So we all think that this is the responsibility of the government, of the state, of the city, of the building, but not necessarily yours or mine. But why is it not? Whose responsibility is sustainability?
Who is responsible?
No, I'm not aware of sustainability.
Yeah, it is our responsibility.
It's individual responsibility, what I felt.
Everybody, in fact, I would say.
Modi.
Ourself.
We.
A survey of people across Bangalore showed that 75% thought that sustainability was their problem. So, what are we doing about it?
I'm about to meet someone who's actually helping all of us understand what sustainability really is and how we as a business or we as an individual can bring it into our lives with ease. He's even gone to the extent of trying to gamify it for you and me.
Smarter Dharma is a social startup that's making sustainability a habit for businesses and individuals in India. How do they do this? First, by working closely with businesses that touch our lives a lot, and by transforming how these businesses design and roll out their products, services, and operations. For example, think of businesses in infrastructure, healthcare, and food and service. These are industries that have grown 2 to 4x in the last decade alone. Second, Smarter Dharma does this through an app that is gamifying sustainability for each of us. It's a bit like Fitbit for sustainability. Pretty cool. And I'll tell you more about this app later. Now, here's something amazing. Smarter Dharma has already saved 850 tons of carbon. That equals the weight of 7 blue whales. And in the next 5 years, Smarter Dharma hopes to have saved 60,000 tons of carbon. That's like hundreds more blue whales. Pretty darn amazing. Let's meet the man behind Smarter Dharma, Sriram Kuchimanchi. He's an engineer who gave up his well-paying job to study sustainability and start something transformational for you and me.
What are we talking about when we say sustainability?
The simplest answer to that is the most selfish possible answer, which is this is sustaining the future of our species, humans, on this earth. Earth's been there for 3.5 billion years, it'll be there for another 3 billion years. Every year, close to 20 species expire.
You mean all those American movies that tell us we're going to die because something's going to hit the
Yes, so one day humans will go off, and sustainability is nothing but extending our life on this earth as long as possible.
Mm-hmm. So we're talking about water, we're talking about energy.
Yes.
What else?
Which will lead to food challenges, which will lead to air pollution. These two are the biggest problems for our survival, and of course water.
Okay. Now let's understand the problem a little better, right, in India. Rural or urban? Where is the bigger problem?
Urban.
Why?
Simple. Again, numbers. I am an engineer, so I always go by numbers. Semi-urban places to urban, richer, middle class, upper middle class consumption patterns, there's a day and night difference. Mm-hmm. The urban India is the one which is consuming like crazy. So I think, and it's such an overused term, conscious consumerism, but it's highly misunderstood by people. Mm-hmm. I think that would set a trend, and in specific, construction industry. The expected infrastructure in India by 2030, 72% of it just started in 2016. So in the next 13 years, imagine the impetus in construction industry. Okay. So the rest of the world, especially the Western world, where they're much more mature in their infrastructure, they're busy retrofitting their existing buildings.
Okay, whereas we are building from scratch.
We are building from scratch.
And what is the impact of that?
So construction industry has the highest It's got nearly 40% of all energy consumed in the world is by infrastructure. 32% of water consumed is by infrastructure. 2016 March numbers are saying that the expected infrastructure in India by 2030, 72% of it just started in 2016. Not just that, construction industry has the largest greenhouse gas positive impact possible. Because see, a building is going to stand 80 to 100 years, right? So if you build it right, over a 100-year period, you actually have that much positive impact if you build it right.
I remember when we were talking earlier, the mention of gamifying sustainability. And that's like really, really cool, right? Using data, using metrics and gamifying it so every individual can participate in this and take responsibility.
Right.
I think it's a super cool idea. So tell me about that.
Most of us will make a decision positive towards sustainability if information is presented in the right way. I think there's an innate competitive spirit in humans. If I'm told that my profile, my age, people, my demographics, 60% of them are actually using public transport every day, I would be wanting to do
that. Wanting to be part of that.
And
yes,
that was something I've always felt. And there are enough, again, like I said, enough examples around the world where it worked.
It's essentially you're bringing about a culture of sustainability
and making it easy for people to do. I think that is key. I think, and the easiness comes from gamification.
Mm-hmm. So one day sustainability will become as popular as running is in India today.
I think
there are marathons in every city every weekend.
Yes,
okay?
If that happens.
Yeah, so we need to do that for sustainability.
You should make it really cool for people to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so here's the big picture. Smarter Dharma is actually creating an interconnected smart world of Dharma. Here's how. First, businesses who work with Smarter Dharma and become sustainability conscious hop onto what's called the Dharma Network. For example, restaurant chain Vasudeva Adigas, which now has an environmentally efficient cleaning process. Builder Mittal, who has developed the country's first carbon-neutral apartment building. Or the Aditya Birla Group that undertook a thorough waste audit with the goal to create a zero wet waste organization. Yep, all of them are on the Karma Network. And now for the second part. Smarter Dharma's Dharma Meter app gamifies sustainability for everyone. I told you we'd talk about it more. So if you've ever tried Nike Run or Fitbit, the Dharma Meter app is just like that, except it's for sustainability. Let's say you take a shared cab to work instead of having all that space and fuel just to yourself. The app will connect you with other people who are doing the same thing, making it a fun competition around who used shared cabs the most. You earn points for all your good actions, plus you make friends. You also earn points when you choose to buy a t-shirt made of organic cotton or eat at eco-friendly Adigas. That's all good stuff, you see. And finally, your points can be redeemed at any business on the Dharma Network. One smart, interconnected world of Dharma. Like, how else are we going to change the world and protect the whales too?
What is the biggest challenge you face in getting businesses to hop onto the sustainability boat? I think the key word is behavior. You mentioned this earlier, but I want you to just go, you know, talk about that a little bit.
So I think one of the challenges whenever we go talk to anybody, right, any business, and we ask them, where is sustainability in your top 10 priority list? And they always say 16, 17. It is never an important thing for them. One of the biggest barriers they have is everybody has this idea that it costs them, which it does if they look at it with a narrow approach. But if they look at a bigger picture of the branding, opportunity, policy, future readiness, it's not going to cost them. It's been proven enough times and more by various studies that organizations which are sustainable are better off financially than the ones who are not.
Here's a look at how Smarter Dharma has impacted a business in the construction industry. Mittal Builders have been around for several decades and have built over 3,000 properties. They wanted to become more aware of their impact on the environment and how to lower it.
When we first started building, we were actually looking at, you know, how much carbon we emit, and just didn't like the way, though we belong to a construction industry, didn't like the way the construction industry actually built buildings. So in today's day and age, you know, the construction costs may be a little lower, but in going into future, you will definitely see that all the consumables that are used in the construction industry are going to get more and more expensive because of lack of resources. And there is no other way to build other than sustainable. And the same goes for the consumer, because at some point he will be paying for those resources, not me. Because those are resources that the maintenance cost encompasses.
And now, after engaging with Smarter Dharma, Mittal builders have been able to bring about many interventions and create the country's first carbon neutral apartment building.
So Mittal Auriga is probably the first carbon neutral project in the country. And I wish all the other builders take a leaf out of this book. And I guess that's the way to the future.
The various interventions at Mittal Auriga include rain, grey and black water harvesting, 28 kV solar capacity via their roofs, organic edible gardens that are both vertical and flat, use of local and organically made building materials, as well as on-site waste management and composting.
We worked on the concept of trying to reduce maintenance costs. Maintenance costs is probably the most troublesome part of being a flat owner, because every month it's a recurring cost. It goes from your basically purchasing power. We'll work on more measures how to take care of it, but presently what we've calculated, within the next 10 to 12 years, if the service vertical is handled correctly, there'll be the maintenance cost should be zero for each one of those consumers.
So in one sentence, can you tell me what is your biggest, most audacious goal with Smarter Dharma?
Decision making, it should now be such a way that sustainability is not an afterthought, but central to the way people think. And that is what we'd like to see.
For an individual, for a business, for everybody?
Anybody.
Okay. I guess also at a governance level.
At a policy level, which is what we work to.
Okay.
Policy level, yeah.
So you run Smarter Dharma as a for-profit business and not as a non-profit. Now most people who would think of something like this, you know, in the sustainability space would think of a non-profit. So why are you running it as a for-profit business?
I was a fundraising head of a non-profit for about 2.5 years. And what I've noticed is the moment you're in a non-profit space, you are having a chip on your shoulder. And
because
you're
righteous about being a non-profit.
Yeah, there's this righteous feeling, right? And then there's this 50% of your time spent in raising grant money. I didn't want to do that. I thought that, you know, you're doing good work, you're doing socially relevant work, which everybody should be doing, and you should be paid for that. And second, a more personal story for me is, I think I would like to encourage younger people to be able to work in the climate change space. And they should not think, let me be 40 and earn enough money and then I'll dedicate my life to sustainability. That's not the case. This is good, smart work, and if you do that well, you should be paid for it.
So you want to set an example in
multiple
ways?
I want to set an example that there's a way of making a living in climate change, and that's why Smarter Dharma is a focus.
So you quit a well-paying job to come and do this, right? What did your wife say to this when you first talked about this? Because obviously the first few years probably were probably without a salary.
She said, good luck, bye. No, she didn't say that. Actually, she is the pillar behind all this. You know, if she was not supportive and she was not standing by, this wouldn't have happened. And she is the tree hugger in a family. She is the one who would beat up anybody giving a paper cup coffee. She could take care of her house, and she said, you know, get into it. Money is not the reason. Money will come. And that, I think, that's been her, and that's what's keeping us going so far.
What are all the changes you've made in your lifestyle that align with this philosophy?
I think one of the things which I've had earlier, even when I was in the US, was I will only eat local food. I love eating pesto. I'm a sucker for pesto. But I don't eat it here because it's not available. I like persimmon fruit. I don't eat it here because it's not local anymore. So that's one of the things I do. I used to drive a lot more there, and now I realize my carbon footprint is high in India. So to reduce, I cycle. I cycle, you know, to work. I cycle to most of the places around. I would have cycled to your studio.
A day?
So I used to cycle about 26 kilometers every day till recently. Now I moved closer to work, so my cycling time has reduced. If I have to buy new clothes, each shirt I buy, I try to find out a shirt which I can donate, which is in a good shape.
So what has been your biggest learning?
The biggest learning is the importance of communication. Sustainability is not a technology problem. Sustainability is a communication problem. It's how you talk, what you talk about, and what are the data points you talk about. That is making a difference. That is going to make a difference whether we'll be sustainable as a society. It's not technology.
Okay. All right. So we've got a bottle of pebbles and words. Okay. Don't look at the words, mm-hmm. right? What you've got to do is pick a word and then we're going to reflect on that word for a second.
All right.
Right. So close your eyes.
And I have to really...
Yeah, and pick a word. Right. I can see gaps between the fingers.
I'm not truly closing my eyes. I don't know what I'm touching.
Let's okay, there. So what did you get?
This is amazing. Technology.
Technology. All right. So what does that mean to you right now at Smarter Dharma?
Technology is our agent to be able to scale the impact we think we can make. And I really believe in that. And in Smarter Dharma, my role, other than all other things, is being the technology change agent. So technology is very key. And it's amazing that that's the sticker below.
That's the word you got. Well, the app's a great, great start. Okay, so with that, we come to a close of the episode. But first, what is your one message to the viewer?
Be a conscious consumer in every way possible, whether it's deciding where you're having a coffee or all the way to buying a house. That's the only way we'll have a sustainable future.
Fabulous. And of course, download the Dharma Meter app as soon as it's ready.
Yes.
And available
coming
on
soon.
The App Store. Coming soon. Fabulous. Sriram, great having you on the show. And guys, awesome stories, many more awesome stories coming your way. So do
subscribe.
Absolutely. Subscribe. Thank you.
Thank you, Lakshmi.
Thank you too.